individual performances by Virginia's junior Burrough and Wake Forest Randolph Childress. Childress was out of this world.
Clear out for Randolph. He's on fire.
This is for three.
Yes, he's doing everything he can do.
Burrough could do no wrong. Strong drop step and turnaround bucket. Burrough. Oh, my. Today, the winner goes to the ACC title.
Backdoor alley-oop. Wow!
Collins!
Raycom and Jefferson Pilot Sports present the best in college basketball, the Atlantic Coast Conference. Today's game is brought to you by Continental Airlines, by Nations Bank, by Nationwide Insurance, by MCI, by Lincoln Mercury, and by Bud Light.
It's the 42nd annual ACC Basketball Tournament from the 23,300-seat Greensboro Coliseum in Greensboro, North Carolina. Game one of the semifinals. The 11th-ranked Virginia Cavaliers, the 7th-ranked Wake Forest Demon Deacons. Good afternoon again, everybody. Paul Cameron welcoming you back here to Greensboro, where the excitement is spilled over from last night's quarterfinals. Some call this the best day in sport when the ACC hits semifinal Saturday. The top seeds have all made it through. That has happened 13 times previous in the 42-year history. Let's show you how we got here. We arrived on a great day of some sensational performances by Junior Burrough of Virginia and also a 40-pointer by Randolph Childress of Wake Forest. Then last night, North Carolina wins and advances over Clemson, as Maryland does the same over Florida State. So the semifinals are set. And if you're a little tired from yesterday, all you got to do as a player know that if you win today, you make it to tomorrow's championship. Now, here to talk about Wake Forest and Virginia, our game announcers, Tim Pratt and Dan Barner.
Dan, let's start with Virginia. Junior Burrough had 36 yesterday, all but 10 of those after intermission. He made the inside lane his own private domain.
Junior Burrough was outstanding for Virginia. I think to be successful in college basketball, you have to combine the inside game with the outside game, and he was really a force on the inside yesterday.
You know, we talked with Junior Burrough. He didn't want to talk about the 36 points. He wanted to talk about defense.
Wake Forest play better defense, because we haven't done a good job on Tim Duncan, Randolph Childress yet, as of yet this year, and I don't think we've done a good job on Randolph in 4 years.
I'll tell you this, he was great yesterday, but how about Randolph Childress? 40 points, folks. He was in a zone.
Randolph Childress simply decided when his team was down by 18 points that he had had enough, and Randolph Childress knocked down 10 baskets in a row. He did it driving to the basket. He did it coming off screens. He did it from behind the three-point line. He just kept doing it and doing it. You had to figure the Duke guys, you know, enough is enough. 10 times in a row, he came down the court and he scored baskets. You know, when they were down by 18, from that point to the end of the game, Childress had 38 points. The Duke Blue Devils only had 39.
This will be fun. Virginia and Wake Forest coming up. We'll have the lineups after this word from Bud Light. Well, they'll be here once again today. The Greensboro Coliseum will be jammed, more than 23,000. This is the first time since 1988 the Greensboro Coliseum has hosted the ACC basketball tournament, and they are excited to do it. Starting lineup for the Cavaliers, Junior Burrough. We've talked a great deal about him today. Jason Williford does a marvelous job as the senior captain. Alexander, Staples, and Dean. That's Chris Alexander. Obviously, Corey's still out. Well, these two coaches, Dan, go way back.
Both on the staff at Virginia, of course, under Terry Holland. Jeff Jones played at Virginia. They are good friends, but I'll tell you what, that's forgotten on a day like this. They're both very competitive individuals.
J.J. in his fifth season, Dave Odom in his sixth at Wake. Here's the starting lineup for the Demon Deacons. It's Travis Banks. Scooter will have to have a big game today. Ricky Peral, Timmy Duncan,
Jerry Braswell only played 3 minutes yesterday, and of course Randolph with 40 points yesterday. Of course, the all-time tournament record. Well, let's take a look at it. We'll take it back to 1957. Lenny Rosenbluth. Rosie set the tourney record. He was on fire. 81-61 was the final. 45 points. Look at the guy with the helmet on for Clemson.
That looks like a Duke student.
I thought you were playing in that game. Just about set. Virginia with 22 wins. Wake Forest also with 22. We'll have the opening tip right after this. Take you back to the window of time. Take a look at our game file and how these two clubs fared against each other during the regular season. Game one in Charlottesville. Wake out rebounded Virginia 40-30 in a one-point win. Game two in Winston-Salem. Tim Duncan, 20 points, 15 rebounds, and a three-point Deacon win there. Both games came down to the final shots, and we suspect it'll be that way here this afternoon.
Harold Dean missed the opportunity at the end of that second game. He missed a three-pointer at the buzzer, and of course Randolph Childress driving the lane and getting fouled by Harold Dean and converting two free throws toward the end of the game.
Take a look at the series. The last meeting, 1993, UVA 61-57, only semifinal meeting. 82 UVA, 51-49, overtime. They're all close, folks. Well, everybody's in their seats. Look around this massive arena, and everybody's down waiting for perhaps a performance like we had yesterday. Randolph with 40 points. There's the guy that really fills a role and has really stepped up since Corey Alexander has gone out for Virginia.
Another double-double yesterday, and here Wake Forest with the basketball. You know, Virginia concentrates so hard on trying to stop Duncan and Childress, it's possible that somebody else for Wake will have the opportunity to step up, and it was this guy right here, Scooter Banks, with 15 the last time.
Man-to-man defense, air ball by Burrough. And that gets a rouse from the fans here. The officials today, Dick Paparo, Frank Scagliata, Rick Hartzell.
And this young man right here with the basketball being asked to do an awful lot today. He's going to handle the ball on offense, and he's supposed to guard Randolph Childress. The key guy on the court today for the University of Virginia is Harold Dean.
First semifinal game of the day, Virginia and Wake. For three. Cavaliers strike first. Randolph comes back. Alexander with a rebound, and here we go. Harold Dean played well yesterday. Here's the tie-up by Braswell. Possession arrow belongs to the Cavaliers.
Well, that's a very important task for Braswell, is to really put the pressure on Dean to make Jeff Jones, point guard, work hard on both ends of the court, see if they can't wear him down.
Braswell played only 3 minutes yesterday, no points. Dangerous pass by Williford, he gets it back. Here's Dean, and he's fouled by Braswell. They may have knocked knees. Harold's got a little grimace on his face.
Well, that's all you'll see from Harold Dean, is a little grimace. He's as tough as they come. But it'll be interesting. Travis Banks matched up against Junior Burrough, but Tim Duncan lurking in the background to help out. The first time these two teams met, as Childress knocks it away, it'll be Virginia's ball. Junior Burrough only had 6 points. So not quite as easy with big Tim Duncan back there for the Virginia offense.
Just underway, Tim Brandt, Dan Bonner with you, 18:47 to play in the first half. It's 3-0 Virginia.
And Wake Forest, an outstanding defensive team. Nobody shoots the ball very well. Now there's an interesting matchup. Corral matched up against Staples.
Burrow's first shot, good. 5-0 Cavaliers.
Man-to-man defense for both teams. Burrough matched up against Burrough. And Chris Alexander's going to get called for the foul against Duncan.
That'll be his first and the team first.
Now the key here, you'll notice Junior Burrough battling Banks, but you don't see Tim Duncan in the background. Duncan guarding Chris Alexander doesn't really get the opportunity to come and help.
Nice pass to Duncan, and goaltending's called against Alexander.
Duncan does such a great job holding the ball up in the air. Watch Duncan grab the ball. He doesn't bring it down, just takes it and flips it up at the basket. Nothing you can do if he's going to catch it that close.
Demon Deacon still trying to put one through the net. They got it there on goaltending. It's 5-2. Burrough walks.
And you can see the attention that he drew right there.
Look at JJ. Broke that hand after the game against the University of Maryland. I think he's become superstitious with it. Doesn't want to take it off.
Well, I don't know whether it's true or not, but I've heard rumors that his hand is okay now, but his players won't allow him to remove the cast. At least that's what he said.
Scooter Banks for two.
And Scooter Banks did not score in yesterday's win against Duke.
He was 0 for 4. Now it's a one-point game. Wahoos by one. Staples. Yes, for three.
And Dave Odom has to be a little concerned. Virginia is very, very good if they're going to shoot the ball well, and they've done that so far today. Oh, Dean knocked it away.
Numbers aren't there. Right pass to Wilford. For Virginia, Banks with a turnaround. This will be called against Braswell.
Harold Dean with the great knock away there by Randolph Childress. How often do you see that? Not very often. And then the great pass to Jason Williford, a look away pass, but he threaded the needle perfectly.
So with Jerry Braswell picking up his second personal, he goes out of the game. Tony Rutland comes back in for Wake Forest. Boy, Virginia, 4 for 4 from the field.
Wake Forest zone on the inbounds pass.
10-4 Cavaliers. Staples frees up.
He drifted a little on that shot.
Cavaliers first miss. Childress, this is for three. Four blue jerseys around the rebound. Ball on Childress.
Tim, Virginia very aggressive on both ends of the court early. Dave Odom saw his team start very slowly yesterday, and you know he doesn't want that kind of a start again today. Chris Alexander going out, Yuri Barnes. Coming back in, Jeff Jones upset with Chris Alexander. I didn't really see what he did or didn't do.
6:19 to play in the first half. It's 10-4 Virginia. Curtis Staples.
Wake with the zone. Got to be aware of where Staples is in this, against the zone.
Burrough, and he's fouled by Duncan. Or was it Rutland?
Fouls called against Rutland. It was not Duncan. Virginia continues to just attack the basket. Dave Odom not happy. His team not moving very well on the defensive end. The Cavaliers taking it right at Dave Odom's crew.
That is the first on Rutland. And 14 fouls already against Wake Forest. So Junior Burrough goes to the line. 36 points yesterday against Georgia Tech. He was unstoppable. He's been on a tear. 23 points against Virginia Tech. 24 against Maryland. He was 10 for 12 at the line yesterday.
Corey Alexander, of course, the unfortunate injury again, breaking that ankle, same one as last year. So he's watching his second tournament in 2 years from the bench.
Burrough misses his second one. It's 11-4, Virginia over Wake Forest. First semifinal game of the afternoon in Greensboro. Nice skip pass to Banks. Can't make the shot.
Great defensive help by Junior Burrough and great job by Williford to stay between Banks and the basket.
Shot. Junior Burrough, nothing but net.
Oh my, that was with Duncan in his face.
He has 5 points. Standing a man-to-man defense. Inside they go to Duncan. A little jump hook. And the follow by Burrough.
Burrough came down to help out against Duncan, and Burrough did the right thing. He went right to the basket.
Ricky Burrough has been a nice addition to this ball club. from Santa Cristina High School in Spain. Burrough and Duncan both down as Burrough went up.
That's what you call a power move right there. And that basket is still shaking.
He has 7 points, and it's 15-6. Virginia.
For Wake to try to find Duncan inside with the matchup against Jerry Barnes. Duncan with a couple of inches in there, and Barnes is going to get called for the foul.
That'll be the second on Barnes. 14-22 to play, 15-6 Virginia. We'll be back after this from Bud Light. Virginia leads by 9. Junior Burrough with 7 points. And look at the field goal percentage, Dan, for the Cavaliers.
Virginia shooting the ball very well. And that's one of the big reasons that the Cavaliers have improved so much this year. You can see what they did last year. An amazing thing that they won 18 games and were as successful last season as they were. But this year, with the improved shooting, the Cavaliers, a dangerous basketball team.
Now, it was after a timeout yesterday that Wake Forest exploded. We'll see what happens here. Childress with the air ball. Dan Bonner gets his first pass of the afternoon. That one comes out of bounds here to our scorer's table.
Now, that's a very dangerous place to throw the ball.
I was impressed by your hands, though. Here it comes.
Now, our pal Greg here is the guy that got the ball. I never did get it in my hands. His basketball coach from Durham Academy is the one that snared that big. Man-to-man defense. Again, Rutland matched up against Harold Dean.
Staples working against Childress. Here's Burrough. He'll shoot from up there. And Duncan with the rebound. Feeling that Wake Forest just hadn't gotten off yet. I mean, they're looking for shots. They've had some good looks and haven't been able to get them down. Duncan is fouled.
Well, Curtis Staples picked up that foul, and Duncan just does things that are so smart out there on the basketball court. He sensed that Staples was in the area, so he didn't dribble the basketball, and Staples hits him across the arm and draws the foul.
That's the first on Curtis, the 13th foul against Virginia. Just joining us, it's 15-6, Cavaliers.
And Rusty LaRue is in the game now, another three-point bomber.
Childress fouled again, this time by Dean.
And that is a place where I think Virginia is extremely vulnerable. They cannot afford to lose Harold Dean. And as Randolph Childress attacks, Jeff Jones knows that he just cannot have Dean on the bench in foul trouble.
That is the first personal against Harold Dean and the fourth team foul against Virginia.
Dean played 40 minutes yesterday, and that's pretty typical of what Harold Dean's game has been like. And speaking of games, that's not quite a typical game there, but we've come to expect that from Randolph Childress.
Randolph Childress, 6-for-7 at the line yesterday, 1-for-1 today. Coming up at halftime, stay tuned for the Continental Airlines Fast Takes, brought to you by Continental, the official airline of the ACC. 15-8.
Well, Wake Forest, the best defensive team in the Atlantic Coast Conference in terms of field goal percentage defense, so you can expect that the effort on the part of the Deacons will pick up on the defensive end of the court.
Here's Rutland working on Dean. Good crossover
on the presence of Duncan.
Shot clock at 5. They've got to go now. Taken away by Randolph Childress. Childress all the way. Burrough goaltending. Bucket counts. And it's a 5-point game.
Outstanding defensive effort by Wake Forest. We were just talking about the Wake Forest defense. And when you're struggling, this is how you get back in the game. You use your defense to create offense.
Staples frees up from beyond the arc.
Great hustle by Barnes. Just outstanding hustle.
This is Staples. He's working against Rutland. Inside to Burrough. The turnaround.
Barnes is going to pick up the foul. Coming over the back, Junior Burrough having a difficult time shooting it over Tim Duncan.
That'll be the fifth team foul against the Cavaliers. Second on Barnes.
And now Norman Nolan is going to come in the game. That's Ricky Peralta going to the bench for Wake Forest. But for Virginia, Nolan comes in the game. He's going to try his hand against Tim Duncan.
Well, what it does, it gives him a good big body in there. 6'8", 245 pounds. And yesterday he was using that body, and I suspect he will here again today against Duncan. Nice free up by Childress on the back door. And there's Duncan to take it away from him. In the lane, running one hander is good.
Boy, what a tournament he's had so far.
He's got 9 points now.
And now they've switched off. Harold Dean is going to guard Rutland. Curtis Staples is going to guard Randolph Childress.
11 and a half minutes to play in the first half of the first semifinal game of the day at the ACC tournament.
We saw Childress give a couple of lessons to freshmen from Duke yesterday.
Rutland for three.
Harold Dean guarding him, Rutland drills it.
17-13, Virginia. Cavaliers have led from the outset. Dean had to adjust his shot because of Duncan. Outlet pass to Childress. To Rutland. Yes, for three!
Didn't expect one any of these teams to run away and hide. Not today.
Outside the Staples. Oh, what a quick release he has for three more.
There's a lot of guys out here who can play, Tim.
So Virginia pushes its lead back to four. How impressive is that? Here's Rutland. Back to Dean. Harold over top of Rutland.
That's a tough shot. That's a tough shot. Dean really forcing it in there. That's four rebounds now for Duncan. Man-to-man defense by Virginia.
Gives it back to Banks. Smart move by Childress. He drew both. The old adage, two men on me, somebody's got to be free, and Banks was. 9:33 to play first half. We'll be back after this message from Park West Auto Parts. Well, coming up next, it's Maryland against North Carolina. Maryland has struggled the last couple of games without Gary Williams. North Carolina's been on a tear, but the last time those two clubs met, it was something special. That's coming up next. The second semifinal game of the ACC tournament here today.
Randolph Childress taking a break for Wake Forest. Jamal Robinson in the basketball game now for Virginia as Curtis Staples sits down.
Was that a picture of Phil Ford? I didn't recognize him with the glasses on. Professorial.
Yes, that was Phil Ford. That is not. That is Randolph Childress.
One of the all-time great guards in this conference. You can say that about it either.
Here comes another one. Childress, however, today 1-for-5 from the field, 0-for-3 from three-point range for Virginia. Junior Burrough picks up on his big day of yesterday. He's 4-of-6 thus far.
Rutland goes out of the game. Ricky Peralta comes back in.
Well, Jamal Robinson looks like he's going to try his hand on Randolph Childress.
It's a big lineup now for Wake Forest. As a matter of fact, Braswell was going to check in. Finally, they called him back, and they put Peralta back in the game. Here inside to Duncan. Alexander loses it out of bounds, but again, Robinson and Alexander doing a marvelous job of blocking out.
Duncan doing a great job again, holding that ball up in the air, missed the shot, but he was able to put pressure on the rebounders, and so Wake maintains possession.
Alley-oop to Banks, wasn't there.
That was a real force that time.
Virginia still leads by four. Under 9 minutes to play in the first half. Williford can't hold on.
Williford had an opening coming through the lane. That's now four turnovers for Virginia. You know, you can't afford to give a team like Wake Forest any more opportunities than they're going to get anyhow.
Rusty LaRue had a hot hand yesterday for Wake Forest. Here's Banks, back to Childress.
Good tough
shot
defense.
Clock is at six. They've got to go. Now Randolph lets LaRue know where it is. He just barely gets it off.
And
that'll be
a
violation.
Good, solid defense. These are two excellent defensive ball clubs. We've seen Wake with a couple of real good defensive series. That time we saw Virginia with one.
Stay tuned at halftime when Dick Vitale presents the DirecTV Dish Out the Winner sweepstakes. That's coming your way at halftime of this first game.
You know, Virginia started off very quickly, but their offense has bogged down recently.
Nice pass to Williford in the lane.
Good, tough, tough catch and shot by Williford.
Jason Williford now has 4 points. It's 22-16. Oh, what a tough shot by Childress on the baseline over Robinson.
You can't guard him any better than Jamal Robinson did, and that's the frustrating thing, trying to guard a Randolph Childress. You can do as good a job as is possible, and he's still going to score.
Robinson forces the shot. Actually dribbled into trouble and was off balance.
Well, Robinson, a young man with a lot of athletic skills, and he was trying to get in between that time, felt like he got pushed. I think he shot the ball looking for the whistle.
Childress, yes.
You know, what is the guy supposed to do? The last time Childress beats him to the basket, so he gives him just a little extra room, and Childress drills it.
Randolph Childress with 9 points. Here's Burrough in the lane.
Oh, my.
He has 11.
Now, Tim, you wondered whether these guys could duplicate their performances yesterday, and I thought it would be difficult, but maybe not as difficult as all that.
Burrough from way outside. Good for three. We're tied at 24, the first tie of the game.
Tough, tough pass. Virginia forcing it a little bit on offense. Wake Forest really picking up the defensive effort after falling behind by nine. And now the Deacons can lead on this possession.
Wake Forest looking for its first lead of the game. Under 6 minutes to play, first half. Good defense by Williford.
It's a three on two.
Left side, Burrough. And he's fouled by Burrough.
And that's the kind of a basket that Jeff Jones really needs to have. Junior Burrough needs to dump that and get the three-point play. Just an excellent defensive read by Jason Williford, anticipating the pass. Robinson delivers the ball. This ball has to get in the basket. Junior Burrough with a good, tough foul by Perrault. But Virginia sure like to have two, and Burrough going to the line for one more. Ricky Perrault doing it about as well as you can. Virginia executing very well. Not much Burrough could do except commit the foul and hope they didn't get a three-point play.
Junior Burrough at the line. You know, when you talk about Virginia career rebounds and points, he is on the short list with Ralph and Brian Stith. He has 12 points today.
You mentioned Junior Burrough struggled in the first game against Wake Forest. Not struggling today.
He's 6-for-8 at the line. He was 10-for-12 yesterday. We'll be back after this message from Bud Light. And ACC basketball is brought to you in part by CarQuest Auto Parts. And what a great performance today by two superior players, Randolph Childress and Junior Burrough. It's a 2-point game, 5:46 to play in the first half.
see Junior Burrough and Randolph Childress as advertised today. You know, the interesting thing for Wake Forest, they got 12 points yesterday from Ricky Peral. They got 11 points yesterday from Rusty LaRue. So the other guys for Wake Forest really performed well yesterday for Dave Odom. Today, Peral's got 5. Rutland has 6. So it's not just Randolph Childress. Tim Duncan for Wake Forest only has 2 thus far in the game, so Virginia's done a pretty good job against Duncan. Now the Cavaliers a little 1-3 with a chaser. The guy they're chasing obviously is Childress. Staples matched up man-to-man against Randolph.
Rebound by Robinson. You know, Duncan got off to a little bit of a slow start yesterday, ended with 15 points. This is Staples. That's 3-1. 2, he was on the line.
He has such a quick release. Virginia trying a number of different things to try to contain Randolph Childress, and they also have to give Harold Dean some rest out there. Rutland has those 2 3-pointers. He's a capable scorer.
Staples with a very quick release, all set up by that great jump stop. Here's Duncan. Dangerous pass, and Rutland touches it last. It'll be Virginia ball.
Virginia reacting very, very well in that zone defense. Wake not recognizing immediately what Virginia's doing.
That's 6 turnovers now for Wake as you look at Jeff Jones.
These are both tough, tough defensive teams, and it's going to be hard to hang on to the basketball.
...28-24 Virginia. 4:30 to play in the first half. 10 on the shot clock. Burrows with the turnaround, in and out to follow, no. And what a powerful rebound by Barnes. Staples, he was fouled. Foul is on Tony Rutland.
And he's going to go to the line to shoot 3. He was behind the line. But Uri Barnes created that situation with a tip inside, and then when the tip didn't go, strong rebounder. This is a young man who was a starter for Virginia last year, coming off the bench now, but still providing valuable support.
He had 14 points yesterday. He's a 75% free throw shooter. Boy, he's hitting 45% of his shots beyond the arc. 8 yesterday, at 9 threes against UNLV.
Comes into the game as a 75% free throw shooter, Jeff Jones.
Can't help but think back of the conversation I had with Jeff Jones early in the ACC schedule, and he says, I like what this club can become.
Well, Jeff Jones has just done a super job putting this Virginia ball club together, and it's no surprise. He's done it now for 5 years.
Boy, I agree, Dan. They love him in Charlottesville.
I'm Randolph Childress. Randolph Childress hurt himself. Looks like he's, you know, got a thumb popped out of place or something like that.
Now, he has had a dislocated little finger for the last week and a half. They're working on the finger right now. That could be huge. 3:58 to play. It's 30-24 Virginia. We'll be back with the Childress story after this.
And replay. Watch the ball here just hit Randolph Childress in the right hand, and you can see his reaction immediately. But look how he goes after the basketball.
Look at Randolph's hands.
Well, the fingers are the key right at the moment, and that's his right hand, that's his shooting hand, but Randolph comes out of the basketball game.
Yeah, but look at him. He wants to come back now. He'll sit out that one play, and as soon as they stop the clock again, he'll be in.
There you see the scoring breakdown. The Childress, Duncan, rest of the team. Teammates really picking up the slack here early. Duncan not very involved in the offense.
Virginia by 6 with 3:40 to play first half, and the shot clock expired for the second time in the first half. And Dave Odom's furious.
Dave Odom is telling his players, hey, you got to pay attention to what's going on. That was, you know,
that's recognition.
Well, that happens an awful lot coming out of timeouts. You got to check and see how much time is left on that 35-second shot clock. Dave Odom can't believe it. Childress out there shaking that hand. Zone defense now. Better find Staples if you're going to play zone.
Robinson with a good pump fake. But then he throws it away. Here's LaRue to Rutland. Numbers aren't there for Tony. Kicks it back.
Childress is alone in the corner.
He's standing by Jeff Jones. Wake Forest can't convert. They never did see Randolph.
They never looked over there. Credit some good pressure by Virginia.
Burrough gets caught in the air. Great follow by Robinson.
You know, Jamal Robinson just pitched it away the previous possession, but then he redeems himself with a tremendous tremendous rebound. Their team knocks it away again.
Virginia's on an 8-0 run since it was tied at 24. Burrough, great pass to Robinson. 10-0 run.
You know, Jeff Jones, when Robinson threw that ball away, he went down and got Williford and sent him to the scorer's table. The next dead ball, Robinson's coming out of the game, but he's just made two super plays.
This is Virginia's largest lead of the game at 10.
Virginia back to the man-to-man, and Harold Dean back on Randolph Childress.
Duncan with the turnaround. That stops the Cavaliers' run.
That's where Wake Forest needs to go. Childress still out there holding that hand.
Timmy Duncan with 4 points.
Ooh, and he just looks like he just popped it again. Wake Forest stays in the zone, and Burrough walks.
There's the scoring run we were talking about.
Junior Burrough, a hard drive to the basket. Robinson just comes flying in. Look at Randolph Childress standing over there right next to Jeff Jones. Everybody can see Randolph Childress. Jeff Jones is telling him Randolph Childress is there.
What a great shot that is.
Yes, guys, that's where he is.
34-26 Virginia with 1:35 to play in the first half.
Williford in for Robinson.
Here's Banks to Rutland. Banks with a big rebound. Reset the shot clock.
A play Jason Williford couldn't make. You gotta be kidding.
Burrough shot too hard. Barnes with a follow.
Boy, Barnes another offensive rebound.
Pushes the lead back to 10 with 50 seconds left.
Wake got a break there. The ball bounced off the official, stayed in bounds.
Last 39 seconds, right guard Pure Power, proud to present the ACC Player of the Year. Look for this feature coming up just prior to the second half tip-off. Here's a whistle away from the ball.
Now, Uri Barnes is going to get called for the foul, and Jeff Jones telling him to be quiet.
That's three on Uri Barnes.
Jeff Jones is going to get after the officials. Uri Barnes really battling Tim Duncan. That is a tough matchup. And with 31.4 seconds left in the half, Wake Forest goes to the line. Randolph Childress goes over for some more attention on that hand.
Tim Duncan will go to the line.
Walter Curl, the Wake Forest physician down there. Randolph Childress is down in the corner having his hand worked on. And they got a hurry.
36-27 as Duncan makes the first. He's a 79% free throw shooter. Now this was the way that Childress had his hand taped in practice, and he took the tape off because he said it bothered him.
Well, you don't want to bother Randolph Childress.
Duncan makes them both, 36-28.
Childress still shaking that hand.
Here Wake in the zone. He'll ice that hand down at halftime.
Wake with the 1-3-1 zone look.
Shot clock is off. Game clock now at 10.
They send Staples to the corner.
Five on the shot clock. Staples with a shot.
Nolan with the tip.
That'll do it. Terrific first half of basketball at the semifinals of the ACC basketball tournament. Virginia has led since the very beginning, 36-28, Cavaliers. That, folks, is the story, Randolph Childress.
Today's ACC action is brought to you by Nationwide Insurance, by Chrysler Cirrus, by Central Fidelity Bank, by BP Oil, and by Right Guard.
Here on the halftime show, and boy, what a great first half. I mean, it holds so much promise for things to come. For Virginia, Staples and Dean are shooting a rock. Junior Burrow on the inside doing his duty, and he's getting some help from his teammates on the glass. But also for Wake Forest, Timmy Duncan scored the first two in the last four. It didn't figure in between, but Randolph Childress got 9 points. The story is his finger, the jam on that finger, will that adversely affect him for the second half? We've got more of that to come. But right now, it is time for our championship challenge, the contest where you had a chance to pick the ACC's regular season first place team. The winner will be announced during our championship meeting at halftime. The Cavaliers playing aggressively and confident right now. And now, let's show you some scores from around the country. Of course, it's a big day, sending for us the top seeds, but later today, Clemson and North Carolina, we hope that the intensity there can match what we're seeing in this one. It's a pretty good first half. We've got the second half to come. Tim Brandt and Dan Bonner have the call.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. There was only one time Virginia led from the outset. They never did trail in that first half. Penn, it's 36-28 is our halftime score. Pretty interesting first half, and I guess the big story has to be Randolph Childress and that little baby finger on his right hand.
Well, of course, I think the big story, in addition to Randolph Childress, is the fact that the University of Virginia has been able to shoot 50% against a Wake Forest defense that only allows in the 30s. Randolph Childress dislocated the little finger on his right hand. They're going to put some tape around the finger. They're not going to tape it to his the next finger there. There's the stats. Virginia at 50%, very rarely done against Wake Forest. Virginia also really doing the job on the boards. Uri Barnes off the bench with four offensive rebounds. You can see neither team turning the ball over very much, and that, I think, is going to be a big key to the second half.
And if you look at the leading scorers, Junior Burrough, 15 points, having another fine ball game.
Junior Burrough, 6 of 11, really a powerful move to the basket right there. He's having a great game. And here's where Randolph Childress dislocated that little finger. You can see that the ball bounces off his hand. He goes and reclaims it, and then he's going to run right to the bench. And here you go. They're going to put some tape around that finger. Now, they taped the fingers together. That's not the way he's going to play the second half. They're just going to tape up that little finger, and he's going to go.
He's got the tape on it now. We'll be back after this from Right Guard.
A game like this is make the plays. Virginia made them in the first half. They've got to make them in the second half. For Wake Forest, Tim Duncan only has 5 shots and 6 points. I think they have to go to him a little bit more.
Wake Forest will have the ball first. The story, Randolph Childress jammed his finger, dislocated his baby finger on his right hand. Now, he had a dislocated finger from last week. Hurt it in the first half. It is taped now.
Childress hurt that finger at 3:58 of the first half, and after that point, he had no shots and one turnover.
Here's Duncan inside. He is fouled. I believe it'll be on Burrough.
Well, that's the obvious place to go. There, Randolph Childress over the last four games. You can see he's had big halves in the first half, only 9 today, but I'm telling you, the game is never out of hand when Randolph Childress is around. Remember yesterday, with 8 minutes and 33 seconds remaining in the first half, Duke led by 18, and with Randolph Childress leading the way, Wake Forest led by 1 at halftime, so they can score in bunches with Childress in charge.
Called that foul on Chris Alexander, his third. Duncan rims out the first one.
And I don't think it's any coincidence that the first offensive series for Dave Odom's ball club, they go right at Duncan. Put some pressure on those Virginia guys inside.
Makes the second one, and it's 36-29. Just underway, second half of the semifinal game, the first game of the day. This will be followed by North Carolina and Maryland. Staples. Tim Duncan with another rebound. He has 7.
Man-to-man defense. Virginia used a number of different defenses in the first half. A couple of different guys, 3 to be exact, on Childress. Going right at him again.
Here's Duncan with a jump hook, and it's good. He's fouled. And 1. And that'll be 4 on Alexander.
And that's the kind
kind of pressure that they have to put on Virginia inside. Right here, they spread the court. Nobody able to get down to help Duncan. Dean can't really rotate down because he's guarding Childress. Duncan can't be unstoppable in there, and they just didn't go to him enough in the first half.
Pinches that one way short.
Well, the key for Virginia was making the plays offensively in the first half, and that's what they have to do in the second half.
It's a 5-point game. Cavaliers in the lead. 19 minutes to play. Here's Dean.
Duncan was the big factor in that. He got right in Dean's face.
Rutland pushes it hard, finds Banks. They kick it back out to Childress for three, and it's around the rim and out.
Virginia starting very, very slowly offensively in this half.
Childress not using that right hand very much at all. As a matter of fact, never even touched it before that pass. Here he is from beyond the arc again, and that was good. He winces, but he knows he's going to have to play through the pain.
Now, you cannot rely on your defense alone against Wake Forest. They're simply too explosive offensively. Got to put some points on the board. Jeff Jones knows it.
Childress now in double figures. It's a 2-point game. Burrough with the power move. Oh, nice move and banks it in. Junior Burrough, he has 17.
He just simply refused to give up.
Relentless.
On that particular series.
Wow.
Jim, you're right about Childress dribbling the ball exclusively with his left hand.
Duncan with a drop step kicks it out to Childress. Three more!
Nothing wrong with that right hand from a shooting perspective. And see what happens when they go into Duncan. The defense drops down against Duncan, and that makes more room out on the perimeter.
Here's Dean. He's fouled by Burrough, but how about Randolph Childress? 6 points in the last 34 seconds.
Well, we talked about the games that Burrough and Childress had yesterday. Both guys picking up where they left off. Burrough just a relentless move in there.
Here we go.
Childress outside. Just buried.
Here's Burrough in the paint. He's fouled.
Fouls against Scooter Banks. And you know, Junior Burrough, sometimes he concentrates so hard on shooting the basketball in there, he drew three guys. And when there's that many guys around him, one of his teammates has to be open. Burrough, however, trying to power it to the basket. That time he drew the foul.
That's the first on Banks, the second team foul against Wake Forest. Burrough buries the first one. The announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Raycom and Jefferson Pilot Sports. Any use of this broadcast without their express permission is prohibited. He makes them both. It's 40-37, Virginia. Junior Burrough with 19 points. What a tournament he's having. By Williford.
Well, you always got to watch Williford around. He's just hanging around. Made one of those steals in the first half, just anticipated the pass and almost got that one there.
All right, there's 15 on the shot clock now. Childress frees up again from beyond the arc. Burrough with a big rebound.
Forrest really very moving very effectively on the offensive end. Burrough just got inside Burrough. Here Childress squeezes it off. Fouls on Junior Burrough. What a great job by Burrough to reach behind his head and grab the rebound. Burrough, we mentioned, with 12 points yesterday, now has 7 today.
He was 5 for 8 yesterday to get those 12 points. And he converts the 3-point play.
We're tied again, and this Wake Forest team has really come out of the locker room playing a solid offensive game thus far in the second half.
Wake Forest. Childress has never led. There have been two ties, 24-24, and now 40-all. This is the reach around, and Wake gets it back.
Jason Wilford let himself get trapped in the corner. Was called for the offensive foul coming out of the double team.
Concern perhaps on the face of Jeff Jones.
Childress saving that hand strictly for shooting the ball. Well, Jeff Jones' team has really not played well offensively in the second half.
Brawl for two. Banks gets it back. Childress from way outside. And he gets the roll for three more. Here we go.
And you just can't guard him when he does that. For Virginia, Childress is on such a roll now, the only way that they can defend that is to score on the offensive end. You've got to match baskets with him.
Burrough does. He says, bring it on, I'll match you. Wake by one. Childress, the give and go to Duncan, and the foul.
And that foul's against Jerry Barnes. Virginia Burnt with a great spin move past Duncan. Barnes now has four personal fouls. Boy, Duncan struggling from the free throw line today. That's something you rarely see. 3 of 6. Duncan comes in as a 79% free throw shooter.
He had 6 first half points. 6'10", 238-pound sophomore from the Virgin Islands and rolls the second one in. So with 15:39 to play in this semifinal game, it's Wake Forest by 2. And we'll return after this message from Continental, the official airline of the ACC. Greensboro Coliseum. And the fans here getting an eyeful, but there is some foul trouble. Alexander with 4 and Yuri Barnes with 4.
Wake Forest out of the locker room really set the tone in the second half by going inside to Duncan, and then Randolph Childress has gotten hot.
15 and a half to play. This is Dean. His shot too hard. Rutland comes up with the ball.
Virginia only 3 of 8 from three-point range. Wake Forest 7 of 15.
Yeah, but the story there is for Wake Forest, Childress 3 of 5 from beyond the arc this half.
As I said, when Childress gets in a zone like that, the only thing you can do is match hoops with Wake Forest, and Virginia's offense has struggled.
Down in the corner to Brawl. That's good for 3. The 6'10 sophomore drained it again from beyond the arc. Wake's largest lead. Junior Burrow tries to answer and does. He has 23 points.
And Jeff Jones exhorting his team to get it done on the defensive end. Junior Burrow doing everything he can, Tim, but you can't trade 2s for 3s.
Back outside of Parole.
Boy, bodies flying everywhere. And
Duncan's hurt. I think he just hit his elbow when he fell. When you're that big, you go down in sections. Here's Burrow in the paint. Staples gets it off.
Boy, that's a basket that Virginia desperately needed. Staples knocks it home, and Tim, you're right. Duncan is still shaking a little bit from that fall he took. Duncan battling inside Nolan with the block out right there. Nolan keeps moving, and down Duncan goes.
They're letting him play.
Well, Dean and Nolan just knocked him down.
Virginia has always been a physical club. They play defense and make you earn everything.
That three-pointer by Staples was the first Virginia score by anybody other than Burrough in the second half. Burrough had 8. Now Staples has 3.
We've got the third tie of the game at 47. Rutland from beyond New York. Too hard. Big rebound by Banks. Tries to take it up strong, and Nolan takes it away from him. And look at Rutland hustle.
Randolph loses it.
Childress is shaking that hand again.
He could not grip the ball with the bad hand. Burrough.
Oh, Perrault had it, but never blocked it. Perrault missed the rebound, and Williford was able to get it, but Duncan right there with the block.
Under 13 minutes to play.
Well, this is what you expect when number 11 meets number 7, right?
Duncan off balance. Numbers aren't there for Dean. He pulls back. To Burrough. Slapped out by Banks.
Banks measures that one all the way across the lane. Good anticipation. Nice job by Duncan to stop it, and Banks just goes straight for Burrough. He sees that Duncan picks him up, watches Banks just runs to the other guy, doesn't stand there and watch. That's good defensive play.
Junior Burrough with the power move, and he's fouled by Duncan. Wake Forest, the number one seed, number 7 in the country. The Cavaliers, the number 4 seed, 11th in the country.
I'm still impressed with that last defensive play by Scooter Banks. You know, a lot of guys, they get beat by their man, they'd stand there and watch, particularly with Tim Duncan there helping out. But Banks just went straight across the lane. He's on the bench now, but he made a big block just a moment ago with a fine defensive play.
He rolls it in.
He's got 24.
And he's 6-for-7 at the line. He was 10-for-12 at the charity stripe yesterday.
Well, as powerful as Burrough is on the inside, Jeff Jones knows if his big guy can hit those free throws, he can really pile up the numbers.
So Junior gives the Cavaliers a 2-point lead with 12 and a half to play. The winner of this game advances to the championship game tomorrow afternoon.
You know, each team sort of playing in flurries in this second half. Virginia survived that Wake Forest flurry. The Deacs had a 5-point lead, and now the Cavaliers have come back to lead again.
Childress.
Oh, he was backing away.
Goodness.
As I say, you just can't guard him when he's going to score like that.
Good defense by LaRue. Dean takes it right at him and rolls it in. Terrific basketball.
Virginia playing that 1-3 with a chaser.
Perrault. That's good for 2.
Boy, he's really had a big game. 13 points.
He was 5-for-8 from the field yesterday for 12 points. Here's Williford, too hard off the iron.
But what a great job by Perrault to tip it away.
Staples gets it back. Dean resets. Another rebound by Williford.
And what a good decision. Good, powerful rebound. Gets it out. Sets it up.
Look at the drop step by the big guy. Nolan comes up short. That's 9 rebounds now for Tim Duncan.
Staples could have done defensively is did the hand check as Randolph went by.
Randolph gives a little sarcastic smile. He thought it should have been the 3+1.
It's not the NBA yet for Randolph.
11:01 to play. A 1-point game. We'll be back after this word from our friends at Budweiser. Ready for the 10th-ranked Terrapins against North Carolina.
We've really seen a contrast in the styles today. Wake Forest really getting it done from beyond the three-point range. You can see there, 9 three-pointers. Randolph Childress leading the way. Virginia, led by Junior Burrough, they're having a big game down on the inside. The unfortunate thing for Virginia, those ones on the inside only count 2, and those rainbows that Randolph Childress is firing count 3.
Childress, 21 points, 7 of 14 from the field, 4 of 6 from three-point range here in the second half.
And here's Harold Dean back matched up man-to-man.
Nowhere to go for Duncan, so he gives it out, gets it back, and Sky hooks it.
That's a great offensive set by Wake Forest. They spread it out, so it's Childress and Duncan on the same side. Dean can't step down and help out. Duncan gets an easy one.
Now at this end, Junior Burrough, 25 points. He's trying to add to that. Here's Dean. That's for three.
Jeff Jones is having any fun, but I know I sure am. This has really been a fun basketball game.
This is the fourth tie of the game. We're deadlocked at 54. Good defense by Alexander. Backside pass to Childress.
Remember, Chris Alexander's got those four personal fouls.
Kick by LaRue. Takes. Identify the player that appeared in the Continental Airlines halftime feature. Call 1-800-836-3ACC within 24 hours to enter. Your secret code is 77. Staples got caught in the air. Get it back to Dean. Great first step.
Williford, what a powerful rebound, and Duncan's right there.
Burrough, and he's fouled by Banks.
Boy, Burrough just really doing the job on the inside today. Jason Williford with the powerful rebound. Well, watch Williford sense that Tim Duncan's right in the neighborhood. He gets it up, but with the pressure Duncan has to apply to Williford, he's not able to get the rebound away from Burrough, and Burrough powers it back up, drawing the foul. Jamal Robinson back in the game. As Curtis Staples will sit down.
Junior Burrough at the line today, 7 of 8. 8 of 9.
These are very important opportunities. You're in a game like this, obviously everything's important, but when you get free ones, Burrough now with 26 points.
Playing so well. He is playing so, so well. Junior Burrough, 27 points, 36 yesterday. Cavaliers by 2. Childress off to the left.
Oh, what a rebound by Duncan, but that's a great block by Chris Alexander.
And a possession arrow belongs to Virginia.
What a great block shot. Duncan sets the screen and rolls to the basket. Just gets those big hands up there, doesn't bring the ball down, but that's an excellent call. Hands solidly on the ball by Chris Alexander.
Alexander with four personals is not backing down.
Well, you can't back down. You got to play hard. If you foul out, then one of the other guys will come in the game.
Back out to Robinson.
That have been critical for the University of Virginia.
Four-point game.
See, Dean very reluctant to go over and help.
Great drop step by Duncan. The bucket's good. And he'll go to the line for one more.
Wake Forest just cleared the side for Tim Duncan. Somebody has to come over and help. That's just too easy for Duncan. You have to make him throw the ball. And Chris Alexander fouls out of the game. You just cannot let Duncan take the ball to the hoop like that. Somebody's got to come and help out.
Tim Duncan, 6'10", 238 pounds, just a sophomore. Boy, he has added 20 pounds, Tim Duncan has. Worked on his footwork. Scouts love him. Gets better seemingly every game.
Nolan now coming into the basketball game. He's going to try his hand with Duncan.
14 points, 10 rebounds for the sophomore. 58-57, Wahoos. Banks gets a little breather. So on the floor right now for Wake Forest, it's LaRue, Duncan, Perrault, Tony Rutland, and Childress.
Well, that's really a critical factor in the game. Oh, my
goodness.
There's shot, another offensive by Burrough.
Here's Dean, and he's blocked by Childress, and a foul on Randolph.
And we just showed you that stat about the offensive rebounds, and Virginia creates another opportunity by getting yet another offensive rebound. Burrough with the block. Nolan continues to battle. The ball goes to Dean, and he powers it in there. Childress not happy with that particular call. Harold Dean taking it into harm's way. Got a break there.
Harold Dean, the Iron Man, took over that point when Corey Alexander got hurt February 8th. Only had 6 points yesterday. And misses it here. He has 8 points today. A little bit under his game. He averages 18.
Well, he's done the Iron Man routine. He handles the ball every time down the court. He plays the toughest guy in the other team. And he plays 40 minutes a game.
Banks comes back into the ball game.
And you can see there, he goes to the free throw line, does Harold Dean, quite a bit.
8:05 to play. It's a two-point game.
Pushing him away from the basket, but Duncan just didn't quit. Stayed after it, beat Nolan to the board.
Tied at 59. It's the fifth tie of the game with 7.5 to play. Here's Dean again. Duncan with another rebound.
Harold Dean just not shooting the ball very well from the perimeter.
Childress working on Harold Dean. Nolan with the rebound. To Robinson. Wisely pulls up. Numbers weren't there.
Oh, Burrough really tried to force the pass into Nolan that time.
Turnover number 9 for Virginia. We're down to 6.5 minutes in the ball game. Childress. He's missed his last three.
Both teams look a little tired. My goodness. What was that?
Staples. Team's on a little dry spell right now. Clock continues to move under 6 minutes. The crowd can feel that every possession now is critical.
Look for Tim Duncan to get the ball inside.
Foul on Dean. That's two. And it's 17 fouls of Virginia, so they're in the bonus situation. And Randolph will go to the line shooting 1-1. And Williford come into the game. Robinson and Nolan go out.
And Harold Dean really looks tired to me, Tim. He's on the free throw line. He's crouched down out there.
Randolph Childress has now hit 36 of his last 37 free throws. Point from his average against the Cavaliers, and with 5:46 to play, it's 61-59, the Demon Deacons. What an instant replay.
And both teams making effective use of offensive rebounds here. Jamal Robinson comes flying in with the tip, and then watch Tim Duncan here. Nolan forces him into a tough shot, but Nolan doesn't get around and block him out. Duncan catches the ball, doesn't bring it down, springs right back up and knocks it home. Virginia shooting only 28% from the field in the second half. Harold Dean only 3 of 10 from the field overall. And the Cavaliers, who shot 50% in the first half, have struggled on the offensive end in the second.
Nations Bank, a corporate partner of the 1996 Olympics, presents this Olympic trivia question. What is the Olympic motto? 5:46 to play. We'll have the answer for you here shortly. 61-59, Wake Forest. The winner of this game advances and goes against the winner of North Carolina, Maryland.
Got a quick look at Corey Alexander over on the Virginia bench. With Alexander not able to play, Harold Dean logging a lot of minutes. Wake Forest in zone.
Staples left alone.
There's another offensive rebound.
And a block by Duncan. Dean takes it into paint. The running one-hander is good.
He is one tough guy.
Tied at 61.
Defense by Virginia. You just get the idea that each of these possessions is critical.
Wake Forest in no hurry. Here goes Childress. Off balance. Great follow inside.
Travis Banks.
Travis Banks, and he's got 4 points. Deeks by two. Staples. Rebound for Duncan. He's coming up big on the boards now.
Staples has missed two open three-pointers in a row.
Under 4.5 to play. Burrough, this is beyond the arc. Nice step by Dean.
That's a tough, tough shot right there. Harold Dean really forced that one.
Randolph Childress taking his time, bringing it up. 3:55 left. Deeks by two. Oh, this is way out.
Childress was almost on the bench when he shot that one. A critical offensive series for Virginia.
I don't know about the knockout punch. Still 3:25 to go and Burrough's in the game. He has 29 points.
Virginia needs a stop right here.
Childress gets everybody in the air. Duncan with the follow. It's good, and they go to the line.
Randolph Childress really creates something here. Draws three guys, and as a result, nobody available to block out Tim Duncan. Junior Burrough picks up the foul, and so there's a three-point play that Randolph Childress doesn't score, but he has the create.
Timmy Duncan with 19 points.
And 14 rebounds.
He averages 17 points. And he buries that one. They're on their feet in Greensboro. 3:01 to play. 69-63, Deeks.
Of Randolph Childress. Harold Dean doesn't dream that Childress is going to rise up and shoot this one. This is with a two-point lead by Wake Forest. Childress drills it. Junior Burrough answers, but then Tim Duncan on a play created by Randolph Childress gets the three-point opportunity. You know, Tim, we've talked about Junior Burrough and Randolph Childress. The ACC tournament record for scoring in two games is 67, held by Len Chappell back in 1961. In two games in this tournament, Randolph Childress now has 66. Junior Burrough now has 65. Both guys within range of the two-game scoring record for an ACC tournament.
Randolph Childress, 5 of 9 from beyond the arc this half.
Virginia almost has to score on this possession.
down by six with 2:45 to play. The shot clock at 19.
And Wake Forest is now actually playing a box and one on Curtis Staples.
Great hands by Banks. Jason Williford holding his back, so Dick Papara stops the game. He also was on Randolph's ankle.
Well, that's just not a very good pass.
Watch the
Barnes.
Look at the right ankle of Randolph. Here's
Randolph
Jason
trying to
get off.
Pivot, but
exactly.
Trying to get up, but you're right. I think he may have pulled a muscle on his back or strained his back. Wake Forest leads by six. There's 2 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in the game. Virginia, who needed a score before and didn't get it, now they need a stop.
Still plenty of time. Two-possession game. Here's Childress working on Staples.
The Childress so dangerous.
Randolph looks at the clock, calls the play. 10 on the shot clock now. He wants it himself and gets caught in the air. Outstanding defense by Staples, who pulls up beyond the arc.
Duncan is going to commit the foul against Junior Burrough. Staples has missed his last three three-point attempts. But Junior Burrough's still been there. That's two fouls now on Duncan.
That's only six team fouls against Wake Forest.
There's the motto of the Olympics. Our Nation's Bank trivia question answer.
Swifter, higher, stronger. The motto of the Olympics. Could be the motto of this game. Here's Williford gets blocked. Wall with the rebound. And Willis is back on the floor. They kick it out to Rutland. To Banks.
And Tim, that might be enough.
71-63 Wake Forest. The Demon Deacons' largest lead.
That's an offensive foul.
It's on Junior Burrow. That's three. But it might be a moot point.
Jeff Jones calling timeout.
He needs one. .134 to play. This bucket makes it 71-63. We'll return after these messages from the ACC.
On the fast break, the Demon Deacons now lead by eight. The fake and Travis Banks trailing the play with the basket, and then he does the old header. That should be Ricky Peral doing that.
Virginia with two timeouts left. Wake Forest with three.
And this is really a tough task for Virginia now.
Possession arrow belongs to Wake Forest. Virginia with 10 team fouls. So Wake Forest will be shooting two. Wake still not over the limit with 16 fouls.
Curtis Staples only 3 for 10 from three-point range. Only one of his last six. You know, you get to this point in championship play, Tim, and everybody can play defense. The team that wins is usually the team that makes the plays offensively. And in the second half, that team has been Wake Forest, most notably number 22, Randolph Childress.
This foul is on Staples right away, and Jeff Jones just frowns. He can feel this one getting away from him.
Jeff Jones' team, of course, on their way to the NCAA tournament, as are the Demon Deacons of Wake Forest.
Two outstanding coaches, Dave Odom in his sixth year at Wake, Jeff Jones in his fifth season as head coach in Charlottesville. Here is Randolph Childress.
And he has just tied the ACC tournament record for scoring over two games.
He also is 5 for 5 at the line.
Childress has just put his name in the record books of the ACC tournament with 68 points. And you got a quick glance at Corey Alexander on the Virginia bench. And a lot of people wonder, is Virginia better without Corey Alexander or not? Well, they're starting a little more tired right now, at least in the backcourt.
Ball still loose. Staples gets it back. This is for three. That's big. Timeout, Virginia. 73-66 with 1:18 left to play. Still plenty of time in this game.
Well, Tim, there's plenty of time, provided Jeff Jones' team can get some steals and some baskets quickly. And Wake Forest, you know, you got a guard like Randolph Childress who can handle the basketball. It's tough to generate those turnovers, but that's what Virginia's looking at now. You got to generate a quick turnover and get a quick basket. If you don't get the steal right away, you have to foul. And Wake Forest, an excellent free throw shooting team, 77% on the year.
The one guy you would want to put on the line is Burrough, who's 58% from the line. Don't forget, coming up next, 10th-ranked Maryland against 4th-ranked North Carolina. When last they met in Cole Fieldhouse in College Park, Maryland beat then-ranked number one, North Carolina. This is the rematch of that game.
We had an unprecedented situation with a four-way tie, had a three-way tie back in 1985. Those are the times previously when you had first-place ties. Wow, an awful lot of UNCs in there.
You're not kidding. And again this year.
Absolutely.
Wake Forest 12-4, Carolina, Maryland, and Virginia all 12-4. Four-way tie coming in.
The Virginia Pep Band, they won the annual ACC Tournament Battle of the Bands this weekend. Of course, I think they trade that for a win in this ball game.
Ball movement now will be big for Wake Forest. They'll try to keep moving it. They don't want to put Childress on the line, I can tell you that.
What a great play. And Childress, he lost the ball, but he very nearly kept it by batting it away. Virginia's got a score.
Here's Burrough. He's fouled. 1 minute remaining in the ball game. It's still a three-possession game, at least.
Randolph Childress loses the basketball here on the dribble, but as he slips down the ball, watch him almost be able to knock the ball to Rusty LaRue. Only great hustle by Jason Williford and Curtis Staples get that ball for Virginia.
You see what Junior Burrough did today, 9 of 10. But he rattles that one around and it won't go in. Oh, what a time for that rim to be unkind. It's a 6-point game.
That's 2 3-point baskets, but Virginia has to get the ball.
They do. Burrough comes up with it. He's fouled by Duncan. Only 4 seconds went off the clock.
That was a great, great steal and recovery by Harold Dean. Junior Burrough, my goodness. He's got 30. 36 yesterday.
56 seconds left. It's a 6-point game. Possession arrow belongs to Wake Forest. Burrough at the line.
Oh,
can't believe it.
They hold him. Very concerned.
Five-point game.
Burrough got it again. You gotta be kidding.
Blocked by Duncan. LaRue gets it back. And the foul will be on Junior Burrough.
Dave Odom can't believe it. Junior Burrough with just a great job with the steal here, but Tim Duncan has the answer defensively. Burrough never sees Rusty LaRue. Great defensive stop by Tim Duncan. Now Wake Forest will get to go to the free throw line to try to build on this 5-point lead.
Randolph Childress was furious. Called his team together and gave them what for? Randolph goes to the line. He has 28 points today. He has been almost perfect at the line. In his last 95 trips, he's just missed twice. He's perfect today. This guy is special. Extends Wake Forest's lead to 75-68. with 48.2 seconds left. And Wake Forest takes a timeout. They'll have two remaining.
Well, you want to bet they're going to discuss inbounds plays.
They did have some trouble, didn't they?
Well, but, you know, we talk about when you're going to come back, as Virginia's trying to do, you have to take advantage of your opportunities. The Cavaliers had three steals down there, and they only got 2 points out of it. Junior Burrough going 2 for 4 from the free throw line, and then Tim Duncan blocking a shot, and Rusty LaRue coming up with the steal. So the Cavaliers really struggling. Looks like they're going to go down to the Demon Deacons for the third time.
If Wake Forest holds on, it advances to the championship game and will then await the winner of Game 2 here this afternoon between North Carolina and Maryland.
Well, that ought to be a very, very good game. North Carolina and Maryland, they split during the regular season. The Virginia bench trying to figure out how they're going to wipe out a 7-point deficit with 48.2 seconds. And you have to figure with Randolph Childress wearing a white shirt out there, it's going to be a task that'll be almost impossible. What a second half he's had. He had 9 points in the first half. He's had 21 in the second half. Junior Burrough follows up that 36-point game yesterday with a 31-point game today. Harold Dean, tremendous effort, but he has looked tired here as we're coming down the stretch. Scooter Banks with a couple of big baskets for the Deacons.
Wake Forest by 7, 45 seconds left.
We need something very quickly.
Virginia with just one timeout left. Staples had to block. It's hit ahead to Rutland. That should do it. Dean's got a fire. He does. That's last touch by Burrough. It'll be Virginia ball with 26.5 seconds left. Dean. Williford gets it back. 21 seconds left. Folks, this will end what has been a terrific run by the Cavaliers of Virginia at the end of the season. They will now move on to the NCAAs.
Randolph Childress holding that hand. Right here. Well, they don't need him anymore, but they need him tomorrow.
Dick Caparo stops the game and immediately calls for the trainer.
You see Randolph Childress on that reach around by Junior Burrough. Got him in the fingers, so Childress is going to come out. 30 points in the game for Randolph Childress. He has 70 points over two games. The new ACC Tournament scoring record.
They're on their feet, Dan.
Oh, they ought to be. What an effort by Randolph Childress. And what an ace in the hole for Dave Odom, huh?
It was emotional last week in Winston-Salem to watch them retire number 22, the jersey worn by Randolph Childress. 5 seconds left, that's it. Wake Forest advances to the ACC Championship game and now will await the winner of North Carolina and Maryland. First final for the Demon Deacons since 1978. Wake Forest goes to 23-5 on the year. Virginia falls to 22-8. We'll return to the Greensboro Coliseum and talk with some of the stars of the game right after this.
Yeah. And the final reads, Wake Forest 77-68 winners in the semifinals. Demon Deacons in the ACC Championship game tomorrow. Hi, everybody. Paul Cameron. Tim Duncan is here with me. Timmy, Junior Burrough turned it on in the second half, but you did too, and I thought when they established you inside, that was the big difference after halftime.
Yeah, we talked about it in halftime, that they weren't coming to me a lot more. Junior had a great game, started out the first half really strong, and we just tried to attack him in the second half.
How about Randolph? Randolph, of course, struggled off and on with his shooting today. When he's on, he's really on, but how about that finger? It looked like he really jammed it.
Yeah, he jammed it, but he's a tough competitor, and he came back in and played the game out. and he'll be ready to go tomorrow again.
You're pretty low-key. I mean, man, you're in the ACC Championship tomorrow. Come on, enjoy it.
I am.
Does it mean a lot if you guys talked about trying to get this far? Was this your goal?
Yeah, from the beginning. We came into the season trying to prove somebody wrong that we weren't fifth. And we came out and we did that. Now we're in the championship now. Nobody expects us to be here. And we're just going to try to win the whole thing.
Does it matter, Maryland or Carolina, tomorrow?
It doesn't matter. You have to be ready for both teams. You wish one, you get the other.
What matters to you is a good shower right now, my friend.
Pretty much.
Great work. Congratulations in that championship.
Thank
Tim
you
Duncan
much.
And Randolph Childress and company. By the way, Ricardo Perot, I thought, did a nice job as well. They got some nice, good help. Not only this guy, but many of the other Demon Deacons stepped up. Thank you very much, Timmy. All right, we will continue from the Greensboro Coliseum, the post-game show. You see Big TD, the long arm, taking it in. Back after this. But, folks, this was a great college basketball game. Much closer than that, as Virginia had actually cut it to within five at 56 seconds to play. This was a tremendous game. Randolph Childress with 30 points. That's 70 for the two tournament games, a new two-tournament day record in scoring. And Junior Burrough, 31 for the Virginia Cavaliers. Didn't quite get enough outside shooting to help out the difference in the game late for Virginia as they tried to make a run, and free throws certainly hurt them. Now, here's our final statistics. Field goal percentage, as you see on the screen, Virginia just two shy of Wake Forest. Free throws pretty much even there. Three-pointers, 10 for the Demon Deacons, 6 for Virginia. That three-point production fell off in the second half. Rebounds in favor of Virginia, and turnovers a push as well. So Wake Forest, the top seeds, advance with a very tough victory here in Game 1 of the ACC semifinals. Now it's time to look back at our ACC Scholar Athletes. Todd Fuller